Hey friends, welcome to the YouTube channel All About Electronics. So in this video, we will learn about the diode resistance. Now in the previous video of this diode, we had seen the VI characteristic of the diode. So if we consider this diode as an ideal diode, in that case, in the forward bias condition, it should offer zero resistance. While in case of the reverse bias condition, it should offer infinite resistance. But the actual diode offers some finite resistance in the forward bias condition and it offers very large resistance in the reverse bias condition. And the VI characteristic of the actual diode will look like this. Now in this characteristic curve, both positive and the negative axis has a different scale. But if both axes have a same scale, then the curve will look like this. So as you can see over here, this diode allows the flow of current only in a one direction, while it almost blocks the current in the reverse direction. Now if you observe this curve, here the relationship between the voltage and current is non-linear, while in case of resistor, it has a linear relationship. It means that this resistor offers the constant current for the different operating voltage and currents. While in case of the diode, depending upon the operating condition, the resistance that is offered by the diode will change. So now depending upon the applied input signal, the diode resistance can be categorized in two categories. One is the DC or the static resistance, and the second is the AC or the dynamic resistance. So first let us talk about the DC resistance. So this DC or the static resistance of the diode is the resistance that is offered by the diode in case when the applied voltage is DC voltage. And the value of this DC resistance can be found by knowing the value of the operating voltage and current. So for example, let us say one diode is operated at, let's say, 10 milliampere and 0.8 volt. So in this condition, the DC or the static resistance of the diode can be given as 0.8 volt divided by 10 milliampere, that is equal to 80 ohm. So just by knowing the operating voltage and current, we can easily find the value of this DC resistance. So for the given circuit, once the operating voltage and currents are fixed, then the value of this DC resistance will remain constant, and that is why it is known as the static resistance. But whenever the operating voltage and currents are changed, then the value of this DC or the static resistance will change. So now let's say for the given diode, the operating current and the voltages are 20 milliampere and 0.9 volt respectively. So in this condition, now the DC or the static resistance will be equal to 0.9 volt divided by 20 milliampere, that is equal to 45 ohm. So as you can see, as the operating condition changes, the value of this DC resistance will also change. And as we move towards the right hand side of the curve, then the resistance that is offered by the diode will also reduce. So now whenever this diode is forward biased, in this case, the DC resistance that is offered by the diode is known as the DC forward resistance. Similarly, when the diode is operated in the reverse bias condition, then the DC resistance that is offered by the diode is known as the reverse DC resistance. So for example, let us say the diode is operated in the reverse bias condition, and in this condition, the applied voltage across the diode is 5 volt, or to be precise, minus 5 volt, and current that is flowing through this diode is 2 microampere. So in this condition, the resistance that is offered by the diode will be equal to 5 volt divided by 2 microampere, that is equal to 2.5 mega ohm. So as you can see, in the reverse bias condition, the resistance that is offered by the diode is very large. So in this way, whenever the DC voltage is applied to the diode, then just by knowing the operating voltage and current, we can easily find the DC or the static resistance. And on this diode curve, the operating condition of the diode can be simply represented by this Q point. So this Q point represents the operating voltage and the current for the given diode. Now so far we have learned that how to find the DC resistance in case when the applied voltage is DC voltage. So now similarly let us find out how to find the resistance of the diode when the applied voltage is AC voltage. So in this condition, the resistance of the diode is known as either AC resistance or the dynamic resistance. Now here, we are assuming that before applying the AC signal to this diode, some finite DC voltage has been already applied. So now this point on the diode curve represents the Q point corresponds to the applied DC voltage. And on top of this DC voltage, some finite AC signal has been applied. So here on this x-axis, you can see the variation in the applied AC input signal. And correspondingly, the current that is flowing through the diode will also change. So if you trace each and every point for this time-varying voltage signal, then from this graph, we can find the corresponding time-varying current signal. So now in the case of this AC signal, the applied voltage will change in certain band. And similarly, corresponding current will also change in the certain band. So here, the resistance value will change continuously. So let us find out how to find the value of the AC resistance when the AC signal is applied to the diode. So in this condition, the resistance can be found by drawing the line that is tangent to this Q point. So the slope of this line will give the AC resistance for the diode. Now here, this variation is the variation in the voltage, while this variation is the variation in the current. So let me just zoom this portion. And if I zoom it, then it will look like this. So here, just by drawing the tangent to this Q point, we can find the value of the AC resistance because the slope of this line will give the resistance for the diode. That is equal to the change in the voltage divided by the change in the current. So now so far, the method that we have discussed is the graphical way by which we can find the AC resistance. But there is a one more way by which we can also find the AC resistance. So let us look into it. So now here, this expression is the expression for the diode. And this expression defines the relationship between the diode current and the voltage that appears across the diode. So now if we simply take the derivation of this expression, then we can also find the value of this AC resistance. So let us see this method and let us also derive the expression for this AC resistance. So now in this expression, the IS represents the reverse saturation current for the diode. So basically it is the current that is flowing through the diode in the reverse bias condition. Then this VT represents the thermal voltage for the diode, while the VD is the forward voltage for the given diode. And this eta is the ideality factor. So for the diode, this ideality factor used to be in the range of 1 and 2. But here we are assuming that the diode has an ideality factor of 1. Now this thermal voltage is defined by this expression, that is equal to KT divided by Q, where K is the Boltzmann constant and T is the temperature of the diode, while Q is the charge of the electron. So at the room temperature of 27 degree or T is equal to 300 degree Kelvin, the value of this thermal voltage will be roughly around 26 millivolt. So here we will assume that the diode is operated at the room temperature and we will assume the value of this thermal voltage as 26 millivolt. Now in this expression, if you observe, this term is much larger than 1. So approximately we can write this expression as ID is equal to IS times e to the power of VD divided by VT, because here we are assuming that the ideality factor of the diode is 1. So now let us just differentiate this expression with respect to diode voltage. So if we differentiate it, then we can write DID divided by DVD, that is equal to IS divided by VT multiplied by e to the power of VD divided by VT. Or simply we can write this expression as ID plus IS divided by VT, because we know that ID is equal to IS into e to the power of VD divided by VT minus IS. So this particular expression can be represented like this. Now here, this current ID is much larger than this reverse saturation current. So simply we can neglect the second term. So we can write this expression as DID divided by DVD, that is approximately equal to ID divided by this thermal voltage VT. So now if we take the inverse of it, then we will get the AC resistance. So we can say that the AC resistance will be equal to this thermal voltage VT divided by the diode current ID. Now here this diode current ID is the DC current that is flowing through the diode. So for the given diode, if we know the Q point, then simply we can find the value of this AC resistance. So this is the another way we can also find the AC resistance. Now so far in our discussion, we have assumed that the applied AC signal is very small. But suppose if the applied AC signal has a very large voltage swing, then in that case, the resistance that is offered by the diode is known as the average AC resistance. So let us say the AC signal that is applied to the diode is large signal, and because of that we are getting this voltage swing. So if this AC signal is applied to the diode, then the variation in this voltage is equal to delta VD and the variation in the current is equal to delta ID. So in this case, diode resistance can be found by connecting the two extreme points of the operation, and by connecting it we can find the slope of the line, and the inverse of the slope will represent the value of the average AC resistance. So we can say that the average AC resistance will be equal to the change in the voltage divided by the change in the current. So let us say a very large AC signal has been applied to this diode, and because of that the variation in the voltage is from 0.8 volt to the 1 volt, while the variation in the current is from, let's say, 10 milliampere to the 30 milliampere. So from this we can say that the change in the current is equal to 20 milliampere, while the change in the voltage is equal to 0.2 volt. So the average AC resistance will be equal to 0.2 volt divided by 20 milliampere, and that will be equal to 10 ohm. So in this way, when very large AC swing is applied to the diode, then we can find the value of this average AC resistance. Now whenever we model this diode, then the total resistance of the diode will be the summation of this AC or DC resistance plus bulk resistance. Now like we have discussed in the previous video, the bulk resistance is the resistance that is offered by the semiconductor material which is used for the construction of this diode. Now the value of this bulk resistance used to be a very small, and for most practical cases the value of this bulk resistance can be negligible. So let me just summarize what we have seen so far. So we have seen that resistance of the diode can be categorized based on the applied input signal. So if the input that is applied to this diode is DC signal, in that case the resistance that is offered by the diode is DC resistance, and it can be easily found from the operating voltage and current. Then we have seen that whenever the AC signal is applied to the diode, in that case the diode resistance can be found by drawing the line that is tangent to the Q point, and it can also be found from this expression, that is equal to thermal voltage divided by diode current. Then after we have seen that if the applied AC signal has a very large voltage swing, then the resistance of the diode can be found by drawing the line between the two extreme points of operation, and that resistance value is known as the average AC resistance. So I hope in this video you understood about the diode resistance. So if you have any question or suggestion, do let me know in the comment section below. If you like this video, hit the like button and subscribe to the channel for more such videos.